Good morning, dear students. How are you all? I hope you all are fine and spending time with your family. So students, last week we have done exercise 2.1. So in this session we are going to start an exercise 2.2, and the topic of the exercise is standard form or scientific notation. Before doing the standard form or scientific notation, you must know what the scientific notation is. Why is it used? Okay. So one question I'm asking from you. In science, generally you have studied what is the speed of light. What is the speed of light? You are saying, sir, yes, 3 into 10 raised to power 8 meter per second. This is your answer. So 3 into 10 raised to power 8 meter per second. This is the speed of light. Okay. Do you know what is the actual meaning of this? Its meaning is 30 crore meter per second. It means the light, the speed of light is 30 crore in 1 second. 30 crore meter in 1 second it can travel. Okay, and one more question. What is the size of red blood cells in human body? What is the size of red blood cells in the human body? That is 0.8 into 10 raised to power minus 6 meter. How can we write this? 0.00008 meter. Understood? So why I'm asking these questions from you? My first question was, what is the speed of the light? Second, what is the size of the blood cell? Because the speed of the light is very bigger, very large, and the size of our red blood cells is very small. So what is scientific notation? Where we are using scientific notation? The scientific notation is very useful in expressing very large or very small numbers easily. If you want to write 30 crore 0 0 0, it will be sometimes difficult for you. We can simply write at 3 into 10 raised to power 8 meter per second. Okay, and 0.8 into 10 raised to power minus 6 meter. What is this size of the red blood cells? So scientific notation is used for expressing very large number or very small number in an easier way. So today we'll do our exercise 2.2. So our first question of exercise 2.2 is express into the standard form. So students, there will be two kind of questions, one to convert into the standard form and one to convert into the usual form or general form. So you must understand this question. The first is convert into the standard form or scientific notation. See these questions carefully. This is the first question, A part of your exercise 2.2. See, the number given is 0.00000067. So means after this point we are having total 9 digits. How many digits? 9. Your first work will be, but before that, understand one question. When we are writing any number, when we are writing any number into the scientific notation, then before this point, only one digit should be there. Before this decimal point, only one digit should be there. So what I want to do, see, I want to put only one digit before this. So what I will do, I will shift this decimal point from here to here. Because I can't put so many zero zeros. No. What I will do, shift them here. Where? In front of 6. Because there is no value of zeros before the 6. So I will shift this decimal point here. 6.7. So how many steps I have covered? How many steps I have shifted? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 steps, na? So 10 raised to power 8. Now the question is, why it's minus 8? Why I have put negative sign? See, firstly again, negative I will tell you, later on I will tell you. Firstly, why I put 6.7? In the scientific notation, there is only one digit before the decimal point. How many digits before the decimal point? Only one digit. So what I have done? I have shifted this here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I have done 8 steps. it will become only 6.7 into how many steps? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 steps na? So I have put 8. Why the sign is of minus here? When we are moving, this is my, see, left side and this is my right side. This is my left side and this is my right side. When I'm moving from left to right, thus left to right, I will put negative sign in the standard form or scientific notation. See students, I'm moving from this side to this side, left to right. This is my left, this is my right. Left to right, I will put negative sign. Okay, if I'm going right to left, it will become positive sign. Don't see like this, left to right. No, this is my left side, this is my right. Left to right, it will become negative sign. See again, this number. Second question. Have you understood the first question now? Convert into the scientific notation. This was the number. I'm start putting this steps here. I put done 8 steps. So 6.7 into 10 raised to power minus 8. Why minus 8? Because I'm moving left to right. Second, see. 1, 2, 5, 4, 3, 6, 000. You know very well. One thing you know, everyone know the one thing. In scientific notation, there is only one digit before the decimal point. So where I will put the decimal point? Here. No. Here. No. Here. No. Here I will put. Okay na? The decimal point should be here. So I am putting here decimal point. If I want to bring this decimal point, see, there is no decimal point in this question. Can you see? There is no decimal point. So I will start moving from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. How many steps? 8. It will be 1.25436. Okay, point into 10 again. How many steps? 1. If there is no decimal point, to bilkul last se start karenge. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1.25436 into 10 raised to power 8. Why 8 is positive? Because I am converting from right to left. One simple explanation I am giving you. Agar to hume jana hai left to right, then I am taking the negative sign. Agar main aa raha hu right to left, then we'll take the positive sign. So one more rule you must learn, that in the scientific notation, before the decimal point se pehle, only one digit should be there. How many digits? One. And that digit should be more than 0 and less than 10. Understood na? So this 6 digit, this is more than 0 and less than 10. This one digit, more than 0, less than 10. So we have done the two rules. The first rule is left to right negative, right to left positive, and the second rule is there should be only one digit before the decimal point, and that digit should be more than 0 and less than 10. So students, this was our first question. All now we are proceeding toward the second question. In the first question, we are given the general form and we have converted into the scientific notation. General form was given, scientific notation we have converted. But in second portion, we are given in the scientific notation, we have converted it into the general form. Okay, how will convert? It's very easy. I'm telling you, it's very easy. You are given 5.23 into 10 raised to power 4. Understood? 5.23 into 10 raised to power 4. See, we'll simplify. We need to just simple this question. 5.23 meaning, remove this point, 523 upon 100 into 10 raised to power 4, same. Understood na? I have removed this decimal point, 523 upon 100. Okay, so 10 raised to power 4 means 1, 2, 3, 4, I have put 4 zeros here. Okay, 0 cancel out with 0. So what is left? 523 into 100. Into 100 means 52,300 is the answer. Simple, very easy question. You are given the scientific notation. Remove this decimal point. Step 1, 523 upon 100 into 10 raised to power 4. 10 raised to power 4 means put 4 zeros, 10,000 means. Then cut out these zeros. 523 into 100, 52,300. 300. Understood? The second question. This was the A part. When the power is positive, when the power is given negative, then what will do? It's B part of the second question. 2.05 into 10 raised to power minus 3. 2.05, same step, do not take. 2.05, remove this point, 205. After point, there are two digits, na? So put the two zeros. 10 raised to power minus 3, we have done in the rules of exponents. Power minus 3, when will it come in the denominator, it will become plus 3. So 1 upon 10 raised to power 3, plus 3. Okay, so what we'll do? 10 raised to power plus 3 means 1000. 10 into 10 into 10,000. Okay, so 205, 100 into 1000 will be 1 lakh. 100 into 1000 will be 1 lakh. 100 into 1000 will be 1 lakh. Now I need to just put the decimal point. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 zeros are there now. So in the answer, there should be 5 digits after the decimal point. So 0.00205, this is your answer. Should I repeat this again? See, 2.05 into 10 raised to power minus 3. 205 upon 100 into 1 upon 10 raised to power plus 3. It will come in denominator, become positive. Plus 3, okay. So 205 upon 100, this 10 power 3 means 1000. Multiply them, it will become 1 lakh. 205 upon 1 lakh means 0.00205. So students, these were the questions of exercise 2.2. Now you can do the questions very easily. Okay, all the best.